everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be doing an area between curves problem, but this one is a little bit different because we've got two equations that are defined for x in terms of y. Normally we're given an equation that's something like y equals x squared, right? It's defined for y in terms of x, but in this case we have two equations that are defined for x in terms of the y variable. And what that means is normally when we are calculating the area between curves, right? We'll have an xy axis like this, and we'll have, you know, maybe some curve like this and another one, you know, that's above it like this, and we've been asked to find the area between them. So they move, you know, left to right, and we need to find the area between them. And what we end up doing is, you know, we have the first equation and the second equation, and we end up taking the integral and subtracting one from two. And we integrate with respect to x. We subtract 2 from 1 and integrate with respect to x. But in this case, because we have equations for x in terms of y, we're going to have an xy axis, and our curves will be something roughly like this, right? And we're going to be asked to find the area between them this way. And what we'll end up doing is integrating, and we'll call this 1 and this 2, these curves, we'll integrate and we'll again subtract 2 from 1 and we'll integrate with respect to y. So normally, right, we would have this equation here defined for y in terms of x and we integrate with respect to x. In this case, we've got equations that are defined for x in terms of y and we'll be integrating with respect to y. So as with the normal area between curves problem, what we need to do is find any points where the curves intersect one another, and then we need to consider those our limits of integration, and we also need to figure out which curve is on the outside and which is on the inside. In this kind of problem, we're interested in finding which one is on top, which one is 1, and which one is on the bottom, number 2. In this case, we need to find out which one is on the outside, number 1, and which one is on the inside, number 2. So, first, points of intersection. The way that we do that is by setting these two curves equal to one another. Because they're both defined for x, we can set the right sides equal to each other. So we'll set y squared equal to y plus 6, and then we need to solve this for y. So to do that, we will subtract everything on the right side from both sides, and we'll end up with y squared minus y minus 6 equals 0. And now we can factor this, so we'll get y minus 3 times y plus 2 equal to 0, and we can solve both of those for y, and we see that y is equal to both 3 and negative 2. So that means that at y equals, you know, negative 2, somewhere down here, the graphs intersect one another, and up here at positive 3, y equals positive 3, the graphs also intersect one another, something like that. So we just need to now figure out which one is the outside curve and which one is the inside curve. Well, we know if the easiest thing to do would be to graph these on a graphing calculator, but we know roughly, if we graph them by hand, that x equals y squared is going to give us something like this, right? It's a parabola like that. X equals y plus 6 is roughly a line that looks like this. So this gives us a rough enough view of it. We know that the graphs intersect each other at y equals 3. So this is clearly going to be our intersection at y equals 3. And they also intersect each other at y equals negative 2. That's going to be our intersection, y equals negative 2. So we can tell that the area between them that we need to find is right here, right between the limits of integration. And we can tell from looking at them that the straight line is the outside curve and the parabola is the inside curve, right? This portion here, this straight line, is more to the right than the parabola is, so that's going to be number 1, and the parabola is going to be number 2. So now, to find the area between them, we just subtract 2 from 1 and take the integral of that. So we want to integrate from on our limits of integration, so we're going to do negative 2 to 3, right? Negative 2 is our limit of integration down here that is further to the left, so that goes on the bottom. Positive 3 is further to the right over here, right? This is on the left, and then this limit of integration here is on the right. So because this is farther right, it goes over here on the top. So we've got negative 2 to 3, and we're going to be first putting in the equation of the parabola. So that's y squared, right? We've got y squared, and then we're going to subtract from that. Did that backwards. We've got the line first, right? Because the line is the outside graph, and the line is y plus 6. So we've got y plus 6, and then we're subtracting from that the inner function, which is the parabola, so minus y squared. And remember, we're going to be integrating with respect to y as opposed to integrating with respect to x. So when we take the integral, we'll get 1 half y squared plus 6y minus 1/3 y cubed. And we'll be integrating on the range negative 2 to 3, or we'll be evaluating on the range negative 2 to 3. So to evaluate on this range, we're going to first plug in the top number. So we'll plug in 3 first. So 1 half times 3 squared plus 6 times 3 minus 1/3 times 3 cubed. And then we'll subtract from that what we get when we plug in negative 2. So we'll get 1 half times negative 2 squared plus 6 times negative 2 minus 1/3 times negative 2 cubed. Right? And so now we'll just be simplifying this. So 3 squared is 9 times 1 half gives us a 9 halves. Then we have plus 18. And then 3 cubed is 27 times negative 1/3 gives us a negative 9, so minus 9. Then, let's see, negative 2 squared is a positive 4, so 4 over 2 is 2, so we end up with a minus 2. Then 6 times negative 2 gives us a negative 12, because we've got a negative sign out here, that ends up being a positive 12. Then negative 2 cubed is a negative 8 times a negative 1/3 gives us a positive 8/3, but because we have the negative sign out in front again, it ends up being a minus 8/3. So now we need to find a common denominator if we can. Let's first simplify all of these whole numbers here. So 18 minus 9 is 9, minus 2 is 7, plus 12 is 19. So we end up with 9 halves minus 8/3 plus 19. So let's put these all over a common denominator of 6. So when we do that, let's see, we'll multiply the first one by 3 over 3. So we'll get 27 over 6. And then 8/3 we'll multiply by 2 over 2, so we'll get minus 16 over 6. And then 19 we want to multiply by 6 over 6, so we'll get 60 and 54, which is 114. So 114 over 6. And when we do the math on this, 27 minus 16 is 17, 11. Plus 114 is 125 over 6. So that's it. That's our final answer. This is this area here that we defined before. All of this area in here is 125 over 6. And that's from y equals negative 2 to y equals 3, those limits of integration. So that's it. We find the area between those curves. So I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!